Talking about active and passive voice, this chart tells us about the assertive sentence in simple present, about simple present, present continuous, and simple present perfect. Now, giving you example as per the chart, if I take an active sentence for simple present, for example, if I say she drinks tea, the passive, she, if the active sentence is she drinks tea, the passive, tea is drunk by her. Present continuous, she is drinking tea, and the passive, tea is being drunk by her. Present perfect, she has drunk tea, and the passive will be tea has been drunk by her. So here we are taking the help of the other word. Next, simple past, she drank tea, and the passive of it will be tea was drunk by her. Whenever we use a helping verb, it takes a third form of the verb. Next, if I talk about past continuous, the active sentence, she was drinking tea, and the passive, tea was being drunk by her. Past perfect, she had drunk tea, and the passive, tea had been drunk by her. So again, in this, we are taking the help of the other words if I talk about the assertive sentences. Simple future, she will drink tea, tea will be drunk by her, she shall have drunk tea, and the passive, tea shall have been drunk by her. Now, this is all about assertive sentences. Talking about imperative sentence. Imperative sentences. First, if I talk about order or about command, then for example, if I say lock all the doors, the passive of it will start with let anyhow, let plus the object plus the be form, then the verb third form, and or you can write you are requested to. For example, as I've said, lock all the doors, and the passive of it will be let all the doors be locked, or you are requested to lock all the doors. Second, leave at once. You are ordered to leave at once. Second, talking about advice, about suggestion, about request, then the form will be object plus should plus be plus verb third form, or again the same thing, that is you are requested or you are advised to, and the answer. Let's take an example. Take these two pills with warm water. The passive of it will be, first we'll take the object, that is we are, the object here is two pills. So these two pills should be taken with warm water. Or if I say don't give false evidence, you can say you are advised not to give false evidence, or on the other hand, false evidence should not be given. Then the important thing we should be remember that if a sentence starts with do not, if it starts with do not, then also the passive is going to start with let only, like let plus object plus not plus be plus verb third form. Do not disturb the class. Do not disturb the class. The question is starting with do not. The active sentence is starting with do not, so the passive will start with let. Let the class not be disturbed. As simple as it. Then next comes that if the sentence is like please or kindly, like if it starts with please or if it starts with kindly, so it itself tells the request. In that case, it will only be, the only way of converting the active into passive is you are requested. Like if I say open the door, open the door is a command, but if I say please open the door, it is itself a request. We are using a word please, it's itself a request. So in that case, it will start with you are requested to open the door. Or kindly grant me leave for today. I am kindly be granted leave for today. Leave for today may kindly be granted to me. Any of it may be possible. Then, if an active sentence starts with let, then the passive again will start with let only. So there are three cases in which it starts with let, as if you are talking about order or command, or if a question or if a active sentence starts with do not, and if active sentence itself starts with the word let, then the passive sentence will start with let. Let plus object plus be plus verb third form plus by plus subject. Let us play chess, or let Mr. Patel handle the account. Let the account be handled by Mr. Patel. Let us play chess. Let the chess be played by us. Let the chess be played by us. Next, interrogative. Next comes interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentences. If a question active here, we'll take, and here passive. If an interrogative sentence, it starts with do or does, then the passive will start with is, am, or are. Taking example for a question starting with do. Do he is not harassing me unnecessarily? The passive sentence will start with am, because here I'm talking about like me. Not harassing me, about myself. So, am I not being harassed by him unnecessarily? If a question starts with does. Does a good posture gives proper shape? The passive sentence is proper shape given by a good posture. So, it's as simple as it. If a question starts with do or does, the passive is going to start with is, am, or are. Second, if a question starts with who, then the passive will start with by whom. Who disturbs you? By whom are you disturbed? Who is knocking at the door? By whom is the door being knocked at? Third, if a question starts with what. If a question starts with what and we have a subject in it. If it starts with what and it does not have a subject in it, then if it does not have a subject, it will start with, the passive will start with by what. If a question inactive is starting with what, then a passive will start with what itself. Taking an example, what do you teach me? What do you teach me? So here we are having a subject as well as the object. So as we are having a subject in it, so the passive will start with what. What am I taught by you? Taking second example, if a question starts with what without having a subject, for example, what causes you worry? So actually, you is an object, but actually who is causing a worry is unknown to us. In that case, it is going to start with by what. What causes you worry? By what are you caused worry? In some of the cases, there are few cases which is to be discussed in active and passive, like if I talk about that clause. If that clause is used in an active and passive sentence, then this that clause should again be maintained its position in the passive sentence. People say that he is a doctor. Here I'm using a word that. People say that he is a doctor. It is said that he is a doctor. People say is already understood that everybody say. People say that he is a doctor, and the passive is, it is said that he is a doctor. So I am maintaining the word that in the passive sentence as well. Second example, people say that you cannot pump the ocean dry. People said that the ocean cannot be pumped dry. So again in the passive, I am repeating the word that. Similarly, if in an active sentence prepositions are used, that again should be maintained in the passive sentence. She is looking after her husband. So here the preposition which I've used is after. She is looking after her husband, and the passive sentence will be her husband is being looked by her. Will be wrong because we're not using a word after there. So the correct sentence will be her husband is being looked after by her. One more thing, if in an active sentence we are using a word going to, that again should be maintained in passive sentence. She is going to read a book. A book is going to be read by her. She is going to read a book. A book is going to be read by her. So here I am using a word going to again in the passive sentence.